there are ways in which the same resume is evaluated differently for women and men. And so this is a systematic and persistent difficulty that women face that is not about their own qualifications, but is about how those qualifications are interpreted. So the National Science Foundation has sponsored for the last 15 years or so a program called ADVANCE, which is really targeting the persistent underrepresentation of women in science, engineering, and mathematics fields at the institutional or system level. There are places in the university where women's careers are evaluated, where they're given tenure or promoted or advanced into a leadership role, where they may not be advancing even though they have the qualifications to do so. So ADVANCE is intended to look at these places in the university to diagnose where this may be happening and to remedy those problems in a way that ends up benefiting all faculty by increasing the fairness of evaluation, the fairness of opportunity.
One of the findings, I would say, from our work is how important taking a systemic approach to change is in support of gender equity and inclusiveness. In fact, in support of any kind of major institutional change goal. To me, taking a systemic approach means recognizing the complexity of universities and colleges. Any effort to bring about change needs to take into account that complexity. And one way to do that is for leaders to think about what are the change goals that are specific to that institution, that are reflective of the needs, the history, the context of that institution. And then a systemic approach to change would involve aligning the interventions or the strategies in support of the particular needs in that particular institution.
It takes multiple prongs of attack, and it may be looking at policies, it may be looking at procedures for evaluating applicants for faculty position or for advancing them to tenure. It may be looking at the ways in which people are advanced into leadership roles within the institution. It may be looking at support for people to have families and to have personal lives that are in harmony with their work life.
The toolkit is a very useful a piece of information for institutional leaders, whether they be provosts, deans, faculty leaders, who are involved in leading organizational change to support inclusiveness and gender equity. When one goes to the StratEGIC Toolkit, you'd find three pieces to it. The first piece is really a user's guide. The user's guide gives a little bit of background of how we did the research that resulted in what we present on the toolkit. It gives some conceptual background and literature background, and it gives some guidance about how to actually use the toolkit. Secondly, the toolkit includes a set of briefs, what we call briefs. Each of these briefs represents a particular strategy or intervention that an institution could use in its portfolio of strategies to affect organizational change. And then third, we have a number of institutional portfolios. Each of those is a case study of an institution that has had an advanced grant, and it describes how the institution has put together a set of interventions in support of their change goals. To me, the big lesson is that change is challenging, and it requires being strategic in thinking, and it requires selecting a set of interventions that together, over time, will contribute to the change goal.